why you're doing it. So this is the area where we really ask authors to think hard about why they're doing the work, what they want to accomplish, what they want to offer, and to whom. Again, these might sound like basic questions that are actually incredibly difficult, especially for fiction writers. I find with nonfiction writers, it's easier. I have a client, for example, who's an expert in raising young boys. He's a psychologist, and he's written a book about, a parenting book about healthy boyhood. But his mission, his own intent is bigger than that. His mission is to help people raise healthy boys, so now he's working on children's books that the boys themselves can read. So you have to create a mission that's bigger than the one book you're working on, and it's very difficult for fiction people. They need to look for the nonfiction threads in their work and really think about what makes them passionate, why they're doing the work that they're doing. One of the gentlemen in the lab came up with the idea that he was really passionate about civic engagement and he wanted to have conversations about civic engagement, and that completely changed the way he decided to publicize his book. So this is really important stuff, it's difficult stuff, but if you can really capture why you're doing the work, fundamentally, why are you in this, what's your authority, what conversations do you want to be in, you will be in really good shape to start the work. And then you're basically answering, you know, do I want to educate people about something? What do I want to influence? What do I want to change? Those are the kinds of things that you want to be able to just have two or three words for each of those to educate, to influence, to change in the underlying side of the slide.